This is how I use Midjourney to create an original scene. I found Midjourney, and Midjourney is an AI that generates art for you. Well, I'm gonna give it a try. Midjourney is now running in Discord. It's a beta. I'm not sure how much is gonna change. I'm just saying, don't get too attached to this. We'll see where it's going in the future. I imagine a scene with a mermaid. It's not a typical sea mermaid. It's somewhere in a jungle or a forest, like a river setting. And in the background, there is a kid peeking or in awe of this magical creature, right? And that's sort of the scene I'm going for. For my first prompt, I used watercolor as a tag. It turns out you get these horrific, horrific images. I don't know how they came up with this, but this is terrifying. So yeah, let's move on. I tried something else. I removed the watercolor. I did a similar prompt. I wanted to do a mermaid with antlers. And I don't know why, I just thought it would be cool. So I typed it in. And I'm just hoping to get a result. I'm not really committing to anything. Just if it looks cool, I'm gonna use it. If not, well, we tried. At this point, it is just brainstorming, coming up with ideas, concepting. I don't know. I'm just looking to find some inspiration, some elements I can use to incorporate into my own art. So I got these four thumbnails, and the thumbnails actually look decent. They're a lot better than the ones I had before. However, this is not really what I wanted, but because this is the first time I'm using this program, I'm gonna use the U2, that is an upscaled version of the image, and I'm gonna use V2 to get variations for the second thumbnail as well. Right, so here we have our four images that are based on the second thumbnail we had before. And you know what? I can see something in this. They still look horrifying, but we have to be able to see through this and find elements that we find appealing, even if they look horrific in this. We are looking for composition, posing, lighting, color scheme, whatever. I'm not entirely convinced, so let's go a bit further. And also because I just want to try a little bit more with Midjourney, and you know, it's fun. So yeah, let's move on. Let's use another prompt, and this time I'm using the tag trending on ArtStation. This is something I found that a lot of people were doing, and yeah, why not? I like ArtStation, the trending things on there are pretty, and let's see what it comes up with. Already, when it begins with this blurry image, I can see that these are a bit more in the style I envision. They are a bit less frightening, and I think I can use one of these. If you squint your eyes, you can really see that some of these would work. So this is promising. I'm liking the first one and I'm liking the fourth one. So I'm gonna order another upscaled version of these two. And when these upscaled versions come in, you can see these are pretty horrifying too. I don't know what it is when you upscale them. Of course, they introduce more resolution and more details, of course. That doesn't always mean they're gonna be looking better, as we can see right here. However, if I squint my eyes, I can see something in this picture, and I'm really gravitating towards this one. So I'm gonna order four more variations of this and see if there are some elements that I like even better. All right, these are the four variations we ordered. And as you can see, they're not really bad. You know, I can see something in this. I like the antlers coming up out of the water. They can be branches, of course, but I like to envision they are antlers. I'm not quite sure about the third one because we asked for a mermaid and it looks like she is walking through the water towards her throne. I imagine this is going to be a throne. However, I like the third one. I don't know what the first one is, but yeah. The fourth one is probably the best. So I'm going to use the fourth one combined with the other one we have already and maybe some influence of the second one as well. And again, I'm not gonna use this style entirely. I'm gonna use elements I like from this, like posing, composition, color, and again, every element that I can use and incorporate into my own style and my own vision for the scene. I am gonna head over to Blender and I'm now gonna start making this scene come to fruition. See you over there. I set up the camera rig. You can check out the full video on how to do this right here. I got the reference image over into Blender. So let's start blocking out the main elements. With the skin modifier, I model roughly a shape of an antler. This will be the mermaid's throne. With the landscape add-on, we can easily create a gully or a riverbed. What I did is mirror this plane and then array it so it seamlessly merges. Using a curve modifier, we can easily adjust the path the river follows. I'm using MB Labs to generate a character base mesh. For this instance, I like the preset Afro Female. From here, there are so many options to tweak. Well, normally I like to sculpt my own characters, but this saves quite some time. Besides, we get to turn this into a mermaid, so that's quite creatively satisfying as well. Putting in the character gives us reference to size. I made the antler throne way too big. Let's scale it down to size. Before we turn this character into a mermaid, let's pose her first. I like the pose that Midjourney suggested, so I try my best to interpret the reference image it gave us. Now that we're at it, let's adjust the camera framing quickly and continue posing. Because of course, the pose needs to look most appealing through the camera view. With the pose roughly done, let's create the mermaid's tail. I use a Bezier curve to follow the leg pose we sculpted. To visualize it better, I want to give the curve some thickness immediately. Let's crank up the depth here in the curve panel. Now we continue extruding the tail and adjust the thickness along the way, using Alt S. With the tail mesh in place, I apply a shrink wrap modifier with this vertex group I smoothed out. Some quick retopology before I connect the two meshes. I need to make sure the loops are matching in size and number before I bridge the two together, like this. To create a tail fin, I use images as planes. Let's cut out the fin shape and delete the excess material. We can blend this into the tail later during the shading stage. Now position the tail fin and sculpt, using the grab and snake hook brushes, a nice pose for the tail fin. To create trees, I like to use the skin modifier to create a base mesh. This particular forest slash jungle has those trees with a lot of exposed roots. Using several displacement techniques, I end up with these noodly edges that soon turn into roots. First though, I connect the root edges to the trunk edge. Using Subdivide and then tweaking the smoothness plus the fractal settings, I create a nice looking connection between everything. With Ctrl A, I use the skin modifier to give the tree some thickness. My good old friend, the zebra mesher, or quad remesher if you don't have ZBrush, allows me to get a somewhat decent topology. I took some of the branches from a Blender sapling tree that is an add-on waiting for you to enable to be repurposed later. All that's left to do here is arrange the trees throughout the scene. Let's do some quick UVs to texture the tail here. I found a PBR texture of scales I like. Let's plug that in here. The usual setup with a mapping node, we can scale the scales. Now browse through the other PBR textures, then put them into their respective places. In the material settings, switch from bump only to displacement and bump. This will actually deform the mesh. Now make it subtle. Find a setting where you can notice the effect, and then tone it down just slightly. Let's find out where we stand and do a quick render. Fantastic. Here I'm using a hue and saturation node to adjust the color. We don't commit to anything, but for now I'm sticking to the color scheme Midjourney provided. Later on, we'll harmonize the color so it suits the stylistic choices we made along the way. A cool trick for the tail fin is to paint some vertex colors. I'm using black and white, because these can be used as an attribute in our shader. Now use this as a mask to blend the image projection of the fin and the scales we made before. Let's scale down the fin thickness to sell the next shading effect even better. In the node editor, we can mix a translucency shader. Also, use the image texture as a color input for the translucency shader. The trees, for example, I sculpted and baked to a low poly mesh, and combine that with procedural shading. For the rest of the objects, I used a combination of procedural shading and PBR texturing. Because we ain't gonna populate the whole forest, we need something to block out some of the light. I forgot the technical term for this, but I made a cave around the scene, which blocks out the light. With a procedural texture to drive the transparency, we got an abstract leaf-like pattern to let the light through. This scene just screams for volumetric lighting. So let's add a cube and start creating fog layer. After fiddling with some settings, it's time to add some color. This makes it even gloomier. Close to the surface, fog is always sparse, and denser the higher we go. We can influence the density using a gradient. We might need to use a converter node to regulate the strength. For my lighting setups, I usually start with an HDRI. Though this is a fantastic way to light your scene, it more often than not is just a starting point. My preferred lamp in Blender is a spotlight. Between the size, strength, and radius, you can emulate almost all light sources. Let's turn off the HDRI to better see the effects of the spotlight. This makes it easier to dial in the settings. If I have more light sources in the scene, I choose an obtrusive color at first to spot the effects of the lamp in question, then dial it back for a more fitting color. With the main light in place, let's add some more. This time I use a point light. This creates a nice effect in combination with volumetric shader. We can use the black body node to keep the colors as realistic as possible. This node uses a temperature input that follows the Kelvin scale. Around 3000 Kelvin gives us a candlelight color. We cannot just turn the HDRI back on. With all these new light sources, we have to balance out each lamp to each other, including the HDRI. This is now our ambient light, which also gives us some nice reflections, of course. I found some free assets and reused my own models to create a spooky candle holder. Now it's time to populate these throughout the scene. This will tie the different layers of depth to each other. And as an added bonus, this will provide us with some nice hair light for the mermaid. Speaking of, I swapped out the placeholder haircut and did the haircut from scratch using a good old particle system. The hair light was a pleasing idea, so I added two more backlights behind the trees. Now this is the time for some final tweaks and compositing. For example, I did change the color of the scales. When everything came together, between the complexion of the model and the color of the water, I thought a more orangey-brown color would suit the scales a bit better. Throughout the scene, we need to mix and match colors as well as possible to get a cohesive image. By adding a leafy branch to the foreground, I was aiming to guide the viewer's attention in a circular motion like so. Dialing in the expression was easy using the MBLab's character's built-in shape keys. It's a slight change, at least it's not a death stare anymore. I use After Effects to composite my layers and do some basic color correction and grading. This journey started with a prompt and some inspiring AI-generated reference images. Honestly, I don't think I could have done this so efficiently without an AI. Of course, there is nothing wrong with gathering references and coming up with concepts yourself. But the AI is a great tool to add to your tool bag. This was a fun experiment. However, I can't shake this feeling I missed something. Of course, what happened to the kid in the background in all of this mermaid? Well, it became an owl. I am so pleased with how this turned out. Let me know what you're gonna try with this AI tool. By the way, it's soon to open for everyone to try. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, comment down below if you have any questions. And as always, stay creative. I'll see you next time. Ciao. Don't forget to subscribe.